One important thing, if you start believing some idea strongly, you will start experiencing it. First stop believing the idea that you will be drained of energy. You need to forget some 10-15 words from your dictionary. I am burnt out. I am swamped. Too much is in my plate. All these foolish words. All these words create that experience. When you start believing, you start creating that experience. I can say these are some of the poisons put inside your system. Slow poison put inside your system. Live as intensely as possible. Existence is not here to suck from you. It is here to supply you. You need the understanding from the other side. You need the understanding from other side. It constantly rejuvenates you. It constantly rejuvenates you, refills you. The disconnection which happens inside is responsible for addiction, dullness, and unable to keep the intensity in your life. When a vow happens inside you, before even it penetrates your whole system and takes over your system, the pause has happened. The break has happened. You have gone to pass mode. Don't pass life. Don't pass your life. Remember, whenever the pass is happening, and try to be more aware, that's enough. Just be a little more intelligent. That's what I am saying, nothing else. The essence of whole thing is just be a little more intelligent. That's all. I am reminding the same idea every day in a different angle. Patanjali is also saying the same thing in a deeper and deeper ways. First he expressed about right knowledge. With right knowledge, nothing much needs to be changed. You don't have to work so much on the right knowledge. That's not a problem at all practically. Then wrong knowledge. You need to work little on it. Correct it. Correct the direction. Vikalpa, imagination. Not only you need to correct the direction, very content has to be changed. With the wrong knowledge, it's only wrong direction. With imagination, the very vehicle which you are sitting is wrong. With wrong knowledge, you only need a navigation. With imagination, the very vehicle on which you are sitting is wrong. I have a story about imagination. One guy brings his brother to the hospital and says, "Sir, he thinks he's a lawnmower. For last 8 months, doctor said, why did you bring him so late? 8 months, what did you do? No, just yesterday my neighbor returned him back." With imagination, very content needs to be changed, not just direction. With wrong knowledge, only the direction needs to be changed. With imagination, very content needs to be changed. The subtler than that, next level, sleep, very road needs to be changed. The very road needs to be changed. That's a nidra. Subtler and subtler modifications of the mind on which you need to work. The second level nidra, dream sleep. Please understand. The dream sleep. The dream, you can see, you completely have that confused identities. It is not chronologically clear. Means the mixed identity. You will experience some incidents which happened in the 50 years age and 20 years age, you will confuse it and you will see that in dream. Means in the dream sleep, even in the dream, you miss the continuity. Even in the dream, you miss the continuity. There is one great tradition, spiritual tradition in India, worked only on dreams. Just on dreams, one tradition of Vedanta, they are called Agoris. They work only on dreams. They master dreams, even Tibetan Buddhism. One branch of Tibetan Buddhism work on dreams. They work on dreams. They master dreams. They call it dream creation. Agori means compassionate, soft. Gora means wild, violent. Agori means compassionate, soft. We have a wrong understanding about agoris. We think agori means violent, wild. No. Gori means wild. Agori means soft, compassionate. They work on dreams. They have a tradition. If they see a dream, that as if they are disrespected somebody or abused somebody, in the daytime, they will go to that person's house and ask for forgiveness. Please forgive me. We do the opposite way. The daytime we abuse, and the dream we may ask forgiveness. That also we may. With them, even if they disrespect somebody in the dream, they go and apologize that person. They believe the dream is an extension of waking state. If you are not daydreaming or falling asleep during your waking hours, your sleep, your dream also will be continuous. You see, if you are able to maintain that continuous flow during the waking state with your awareness, in the dream state also, you will be able to maintain that continuity. They use that dream state to solve all their problems, to find out the mysteries of the planet Earth and the universe. This great mathematician Ramanujan from South India, he had mastery over dream. Any problem, he will just contemplate in the night and go to fall asleep. In the dream, he will have solution. Next day morning, he will just repeat the solution. He doesn't know the way how he settled. He says, I don't know the method, but I know the result. That's why somebody started suspecting that he may be stealing the answers from others. If somebody asks, how do you know the answer? He's a great devotee of Solingapuram Mahalakshmi. There's a Devi, Lakshmi Narasimha. Narasimha is the incarnation of Vishnu. He's a great devotee of that Lakshmi Narasimha. He says, though Solingapuram Mahalakshmi told me, that's all. He has mastered the dreams. If you are able to be aware, even while the dream continues, you will use your dream to enrich your life. Please understand, if you can master this art, God, I can say, your whole life will be totally different. You can achieve straight away whatever you want. Mastering your dream means being aware even while you are dreaming. Not letting that breaking or the pass happen while you dream. You may ask how to do. There is a beautiful technique, very powerful technique from Tantra. Visualize something which you like. Even Patanjali speaks about the technique. He gives in Vibhudipada. He gives in next Sadhana Pada and Vibhudipada about the technique. Whatever makes you feel very pleasant, something, if some person, if you feel very pleasant by remembering your master, or by remembering your beloved, or by remembering some scene like a beach, if you feel very pleasant about somebody or something, just remember that alive inside while you fall asleep. Lie down in your bed. Just remember that alive, vivid, visually, in multicolor, four dimension, vividly remember and continue to be with that till you fall asleep. Try this just for 10 days. You will see that vivid picture, vivid visualization, that vivid experience will penetrate your dream state within 10 days. And that will continue to be there throughout your dream, means you have mastered the dream. You may think, how can this happen in just 10 days? Try, you will see. But only one condition. You have to choose something which really makes you pleasant. By remembering it, you feel very pleasant. You will continue. You will not have that dream sleep. If you have this, if you master this, you will not have dream sleep. Please understand. Patanjali is talking about many mystical dimensions. He is talking about all these things to awaken those mystical dimensions in you. Life is not just all about having a, what you call good life. Just few cars, few houses and a family. Patanjali gives all these methods and techniques to awaken the higher energies inside you. He is not talking, he is not interested just to stop your that good life. What you call it, good life? No. What you say, that family, house and money and health? No, he says, no, that is not all about life. There are so many other things which you can experience if you have human body. It's like, you see, what is good life, you know? You go to Hawaii and you know all the most frequented places. You stay there for a few days and you see only those few places and come back. That may be equated as a good life. But seeing every place, experiencing everything is what I call complete life, yogic life. That is what here Patanjali wants you to live. You come here and what you call that? The definition, you see, whenever you go to a new place, you know the tourist guide is there. The tourist guide will say few places which they got sponsor, that's all. They would have got sponsor from few people, about those few hotels, few restaurants and few beaches and few places they will talk about, and you do that one or two things and come back. Same thing most of us do in the planet Earth. When you come here, you see the tourist guide which your parents are carrying. And you say, one marriage, one house, two, three car, little bank balance. You do that and go back. Understand, that is not complete life. There are so many things which are hidden, deep secrets, which needs to be lived. Awaken those energies, those possibilities. Especially if you can stop that dream sleep. So many things can happen. Even in the dream sleep, there are two subtle categories. When you are dreaming, the discontinuity which happens with the dream and the discontinuity which happens with inside you. Just like in the waking state, two dreams, two sleep. The waking state, you have two sleep. Sleeping in the action, sleeping in the thinking. Same way in the dream state. Sleeping in the dreaming, sleeping in the thinking. The next is sleep. This is the ultimate sleep. Understand? You may think, what can we do about sleep? If you work on the dream state and go deeper and deeper. See, if you are working on the dream state, let me explain this very clearly. How to work on the dream state. If you are interested in working on the dream state, take up this technique. It will be very powerful. Every day I am going to talk about the techniques which is with Patanjali is expressing. If you can work, continue to work that day itself. If you can't, at least play with some technique. One or two, you will see new doors opening. Working on the dream. As I told you, take up a pleasant object or a thing. If it is a person, it will be really nice because you can easily meditate on him, connect with him, feel him. Feel him inside your inner space, visually, alive. Just go to fall asleep with that one intense visualization. In 10 days you will see, he is there continuously, you will see his form in the dream. Clearly, in multicolor. Means, you have mastered, you have created a continuity in the dream. Now you have mastered how to avoid dream sleep. If you continue the same thing, maybe after 3 months, in the deep sleep, you will have his presence, energy, but not the form. When you wake up, you know you have been with master throughout, but you did not remember his form, that color, dreads, hair, you did not remember all that, but you know for sure you are with him. Please understand, this is what is real Shivaratri. This is what is real Shivaratri. Krishna says in Gita, yogi is a person who does not sleep when everybody sleeps. This is what he means. You are awake throughout. Your consciousness is awake throughout. Try this technique. You will master waking sleep, dream sleep, and sleep sleep. You will have that continuity in all three states. That is what we call Turiya, fourth state. If you are continuous, unbroken in all three states, you experience, what you experience is called fourth state, Turiya. By describing the sleep, Nidra, all Patanjali wants us to understand is the subtle state where thoughts are not visualized is sleep or Nidra. Now, try to be continuous throughout the Nidra, not only the sleep which is happening in the deep sleep time, the sleep which is happening all the three times. Be continuous so that it can lead you to joy. If you are not maintaining that continuity, if you are falling asleep, day sleep, dream sleep, deep sleep, it will lead you to more and more anguish and pain, which is happening in all of us, which is happening in our life. So understand, try to maintain. Try to create the continuity. People ask me, if I am continuous, then how will I rest, relax? Understand, that continuity itself will be such a deep, restful awareness. It will not be restless awareness. Don't think, it will be like a load on you. Sometimes if you don't fall asleep in the, if you don't sleep in the light night, early morning you feel tired. It will not be like that. In that time, you have not slept, but you are thinking continuously, all broken ideas. It's like a garage sale. You collected all the things and you are completely confused with your objects. How to organize and how to market and how to praise, and you are suffering with it. Please understand, if you have not slept and early morning you are tired, you have done garage sale whole night. Whole night you have been doing garage sale. I am not talking about that mode. If you create that continuity, that very continuity will be the deep, restful awareness. I can say that is the ultimate break you can give for yourself. Now, you don't have break. Break is not under your control. The continuity is the ultimate break. It looks paradox. Please understand. It looks paradox. Now you think you have a break. You have a break sleeping, dream, waking. You think you have a break. That is not a break. Continuity. Having the continuity, mastery over the break is a break. Understand? Now there is a break, but you don't know when it will break. Mastery over the break is the real break. I have a story for you about break. A huge fire broke out near a farm. The county fire department were called out, but the blaze was too big for them to tackle. So a call for additional assistance was made to a part-time volunteer force. The volunteer brigade turned up in a dilapidated old truck, which spluttered along the track leading to the fire. The county fire chief was about to apologize the farmer for the embarrassment the volunteer force was causing, when to his amazement, the volunteer truck fearlessly drove into the very heart of the fire. Within minutes, the center of the fire was extinguished, breaking the blaze into two controllable sections. An hour later, the entire fire was out. The farmer was so impressed that he immediately presented the captain of the volunteer force a check for $1,000. The local newspaper man asked the captain what he was going to spend it on. The guy says, "I'm going to get the brakes on the damn truck fixed." If you can break your brake, only then it is break. Otherwise, it can't be break. If you catch that continuity, you can break at any time. You can break at any time. The break is under your control. So, let us break now. Understand these great ideas from Patanjali. Experience these meditations and catch that continuity, fourth state. Living in the fourth state is what I call living enlightenment, Jivan Mukti. Let you all achieve and radiate the living enlightenment state, Jivan Mukti. Let you all experience and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda.